Hi everyone, today we are going to be talking about some phenomenal dupes that I've found for some brand new Charlotte Tilbury skincare. The Magic Hydrator Mist and the Magic Water Cream, which is taking the internet by storm. Every single advert that I view when I'm on YouTube is for this cream. I mean, they must think I need it in my life, and I must say, it is stunning. So I've not always been a huge fan of the Charlotte Tilbury skincare line. I do think some products are very nice, but highly overpriced. Others are just hard passes for me. I just don't like them at all. They don't suit my skin, and I wouldn't put them anywhere near me. However, both of these products are very nice in their own right. So both of these will quench the skin's thirst, giving a mass of hydration. They'll also both improve the skin barrier, soothing, smoothing, plumping, balancing, and giving your skin that really nice radiant glow that comes with filling your skin full of hydration and just plumpness and youthfulness and just gorgeousness. So I think I found two products that will rival these and are a lot more inexpensive. So if you're on a low buy or if you just cannot justify spending this amount on skincare, then you are going to want to stick around because I have some dupes for you. So if you've been a regular to my channel for quite some time, you will know that I don't drop the word dupe lightly. I like to do my research, I like to cross all my I's, dot all my T's, I like to test out the products within an inch of their lives just to make sure that all the boxes are ticked. So all the products need to do the same thing. All the products need to have a similar texture. They have to apply to the skin in the same way. They have to make the skin look the same once both products have absorbed. And they have to have very similar or identical ingredients. So I feel like tick, tick, tick. We are there. Let's get on with it. If you're new here, hi, my name's Gemma. I upload new content on YouTube every single week. I would love it if you'd come and join the family by clicking the like button, the subscribe button, and the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos like these. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank YesStyle for sponsoring this video today. Let's get straight on with it. We're going to talk about the Magic Hydrator Mist first. So the Magic Hydrator Mist, again, gives masses of hydration. It's instantly cooling, calming, refreshing on the skin. It feels really beautiful and lightweight, and you can apply this below or above makeup. I personally don't apply this or the dupe for this product over the top of makeup because I just think it hinders the longevity of my makeup. That may not be the same for you. And if you have really dry areas, just applying a little bit of this throughout the day over your dry areas may be just the thing you need. So really lovely product, but again, I have a dupe for this. So my dupe is from Claire's. This is the Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist. It is stunning. So we're going to talk about the price first because there is a huge difference. So prices and quantities, we've got the Magic Hydrator Mist for £35 and you get 75 mils of product. That works out at 47 pence per milliliter or £47 per 100 mils. And I'll put you the dollar conversion on there as well. Then we've got the Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist, which gives exactly the same results for £16 for 125 mils, which works out at 13 pence per milliliter or £13 per 100 mils. Both of them absolutely glorious. So let's talk about the similarities and then we'll talk about a couple of differences. Looking at the packaging side by side, there are very few similarities. However, both have a pump and both give out a really fine mist. Now, the Charlotte Tilbury product gives out less liquid per pump and the pump action is slightly longer. So it gives the impression that the mist is finer than the Claire's. However, I don't think it actually is, and please bear in mind that the mist on the Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist is also super, super fine. I think it's just the packaging and the pump action that makes the Charlotte Tilbury feel more luxurious. Feeling both products in two different hands, they feel the same weight. So the Charlotte Tilbury product is definitely a chunkier, more solid bottle and therefore feels more luxurious in that sense. You only get 75 mils in here and it feels the same weight as something with 125 mils of product in. And in fact, it doesn't really have 125 mils of product in anymore because this is the one that I reach for over this one. So it's got a lot less than 125 mils in here and they still feel like they're the same weight. The texture and the consistency of both products is really watery, extremely lightweight, silky smooth and easily absorbed by the skin. There's a similar, slightly tacky feel on the skin which subsides after a few minutes. I've got to say that the Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist subsides a little bit quicker than the tackiness of the Magic Hydrator Mist, which tends to linger a little bit longer. Both also give the skin that beautiful dewy glow. Let's talk about the ingredients. Both of them have glycerin, tralose, sodium hyaluronate for hydrating, and both are alcohol free. The differences in the ingredients are subtle. So the Charlotte Tilbury has pentylene glycol, whereas the Claire's has butylene glycol. Both of these are humectants and also moisturizers as well. The Charlotte Tilbury has urea for exfoliation and also hydration, whereas the Claire's has rice extract for exfoliation, both work in a similar way, just slightly different ingredients. The Charlotte Tilbury has niacinamide in there to look after the skin barrier, whereas the Claire's has ceramides to do a similar thing. The main difference in both of these is that the Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist is fragrance and essential oil free, whereas the Charlotte Tilbury one is not. And if you are sensitive to fragrance, dodge this with a barge pole because it is potent. Let's just say that every time I apply this, I feel like I'm applying an actual fragrance to my face. It is strong. It's lovely. But it's strong, really, really strong. And I think a lot of people like to apply hydrating mist when they're traveling, when they're on an aeroplane. I would not apply this when I'm aboard an aeroplane. People around you, in fact, in the entire plane, they would not thank you for it. I mean, it's like when they take the duty-free cart up and down the aisles and somebody starts testing fragrances out that they've just bought from duty-free. And you think, thank you very much. This is recirculated air and I do not want my vodka and orange tasting of your Chanel Mademoiselle. Thank you very much, miss. Please spray that when you get off. People would not thank you for spraying this when it's recirculated air. It's just super, super strong. So if you are thinking about traveling, this one, definitely the one to take with you. The Charlotte Tilbury product also really amusingly says avoid contact with eyes on the instructions. Not sure how you can do that with this being a mist for the face, and there is no way that you can actually aim this because the mist is so fine. So you're gonna get this on the eyelids and then there is a possibility that that will then migrate into the eyes. I'm assuming this is a problem with the fragrance being in the formula and that fragrance may irritate the eyes. But I mean, don't quote me on that. I'm assuming here, but yeah, it does say that on the instructions. Interesting. So that's it for these two. I hands down prefer the Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist over the Charlotte Tilbury for the main reason that you get more for your money and who doesn't like that? And also this one is so punchy on the fragrance that it's a bit too much for me. I like to choose my own fragrance. I don't want to douse myself in something that's been chosen for me. So yeah, it's this one all the way. It does everything that the Charlotte Tilbury product does. It feels the same, it makes your skin look the same, but it's just a lot more affordable. Moving on to the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Water Cream. Now, if you're wondering why this is so small, I only purchased the mini version, and after finding the dupe, I'm so glad that I did, because what a waste that would have been. So yeah, we're going to talk about the Magic Water Cream. This is just the miniature version. This is hydrating, it's reviving, it's skin barrier improving. It smooths, it plumps, it balances, and it gives a dewy, hydrated glow, but so does my dupe. So let's talk about that now. I actually talked about this product in my recent video that I did on Beauty of Joseon. If you haven't seen that already, I will link that up here for you. It is a phenomenal moisturizer. Still my beating heart. It is just so refreshing and lightweight, and yet packs a punch with hydration, just like the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Water Cream. Very, very similar texture. There is a slight difference in weight, and I'll get onto that in just a second, but it feels the same on the skin. It looks the same on the skin, with very similar and some identical ingredients. It does everything that you want it to do. This is from Beauty of Joseon, and it's the Dynasty Cream. And never mind the word magic in the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Water Cream. This is actually where the magic happens. It is stunning. It is juicy. It is everything I want from a moisturizer, and so super lightweight and more affordable as well. So the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Water Cream is £79 for 50 mils worth of product, which is £1.58 per milliliter, or hold on to your hats, £158 per 100 mils. Whereas the Beauty of Joseon Dynasty Cream is £16 for the same amount of product, 50 mils, which works out at 32 pence per milliliter, or £32 per 100 mils. That's almost five times more affordable than the Charlotte Tilbury cream. I mean, come on. So let's talk about the similarities. Both products come in a glass container with a plastic lid. Granted, the Beauty of Joseon is far more basic, and the Charlotte Tilbury, with its octagonal shape and design, looks and feels more luxurious to hold, but both of them similar packaging. The texture and consistency of both are very gel-like and lightweight. Both of them penetrate the skin beautifully and absorb quickly, leaving the skin feeling smooth and hydrated with a beautiful, dewy, hydrated glow. Moving on to ingredients, both are fragrance, essential oil, and alcohol-free. Both have humectants, glycerin, sodium hyaluronate, and propanadiol for hydration. Both have the emollients, caprylic triglyceride, and squalane to nourish and smooth, and both have the antioxidant niacinamide in there to look after the skin barrier. Let's talk about a few subtle differences, and these are incredibly subtle. All these ingredients do a very similar job, but they are different ingredients. So Charlotte Tilbury decided to use pentylene glycol within her formula, exactly the same as with the Magic Hydrator Mist, whereas Beauty of Joseon decided to use butylene glycol in their formula. Now, butylene glycol tends to be a little bit less irritating than pentylene glycol, so I was a little bit surprised that the Charlotte Tilbury brand decided to go for pentylene glycol over butylene glycol, but both are very, very tolerated ingredients anyway. It's just pentylene glycol is slightly more irritating to some. Charlotte Tilbury also used camellia seed oil and sunflower seed oil for emollients, where a Beauty of Joseon decided to use safflower seed oil and hydrogenated coconut oil for emollients instead. Charlotte Tilbury used peptides to smooth and improve, whereas Beauty of Joseon concentrated more on the skin barrier function and soothing with ceramides, honey extract, and adenoside, which really gives a lot of help to the skin for healing. Like I said right at the beginning of this segment, there is a very subtle difference between consistency and texture of both of these products. Now, I am splitting hairs. It is so, so subtle, but I'm going to talk about the differences between both of the products now. So we're going to start off with that one first. So the Beauty of Joseon is really light and loose, and due to that, It really does penetrate the skin beautifully well. It absorbs very, very quickly. There is a slight tackiness on the surface of the skin. However, that does subside incredibly quickly, just like the Claire's Fundamental Ampoule Mist that I spoke about earlier on. The Charlotte Tilbury Water Cream, however, does include the ingredient shea butter within the formula. There's only a little bit within the formula, but it does make a difference to the consistency. It's slightly thicker in texture, and it's only slight, but it does need to be mentioned because this does hinder absorption. It does stay on the surface of the skin for a tiny bit longer, and that tackiness takes a little bit longer to subside. But the main difference I want to talk about is obviously quite self-explanatory. It's the price. £158 per 100 mils for the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Water Cream, £32 per 100 mils for the Beauty of Joseon Dynasty Cream. And they do the same thing. So regardless of price, both of the formulas feel expensive on the skin. They are both stunning. So I guess it depends on your preference and also your budget. If you love that luxury that the packaging of Charlotte Tilbury can give you, fragrance from Charlotte Tilbury can give you with the Magic Hydrator Mist, then the Charlotte Tilbury products are going to be for you. However, if you're willing to sacrifice a little bit of luxury, try out these dupes because I don't think you're going to be disappointed. Please give this video a like if you found it helpful and consider subscribing and clicking that notification bell so you don't miss any future videos like these. Also, please don't forget to check out the links in the description box for all the products I've talked about in this video, and hope to see you all in the next one. Bye everyone.